In this episode, I'm talking about thermosets and their general properties. In this episode, what I put up here are all thermoset parts. So we range from processes that just use thermoset, like the VAT photopolarization process, these two towers, and this dental guide, material jetting, where we only dispense droplets of a thermoset. Then a variation, the also called, often called digital light synthesis, but the variation of VAT photopolymerization. And then the binder jetting process, where we this is actually sand, or probably plaster of Paris, and we use colored thermoset resin as the binder. So just to remind you, those were the different variations we learned about in the basic section. And you've seen that schematic already before, but now we're focusing on the thermosets, these cross-linked molecule chains that have covalent bonds between those elongated polymer chains. And because thermosets are a highly cross-linked network polymer, so giant macromolecules, so not it's not macromolecules, plural, it's actually one giant macromolecule. It has strong covalent bonds instead of the entanglements, and that has a very, it results in a very different property set. We start again with a liquid at room temperature. Very low viscosity can flow more like water, and these liquid components of different monomers are mixed, and a solid state is then reached through curing and the cross-linking, the formation of these covalent bonds, first in the chains and then in the bonds between. Because it's a chemical reaction that's happening here, this is not reversible. You can't really go from a thermoset solid resin to the monomers. There's a couple of things that can happen, but in general, that's not possible. It's not reversible. Because of the covalent bonds, these materials are more brittle than thermoplastics. And the cross-linking results in a higher glass transition temperature and a higher thermal stability than we have with thermoplastics. So you don't see that softening that we now know from thermoplastics. Before they degrade at some temperature that they can't withstand. The thermosets don't have any softening step. They just degrade once we reach 450 degrees C or around that temperature. And also because of the covalent bonds, thermosets are very resistant to solvents. Here I have a reaction example that's really just very basic. But if you have two monomers, the AA and BB, as an example, and these two polymerize, so they react here between an A and a B, you get a linear polymer. But if you have monomers that also have side groups, like the B in this case, that is B, three B atoms, then you have the possibility, as you see here, you form that linear polymer, but because of this B as a side group, the AA can also dock there, react there, and you can create this networked molecule. And that's what's really happening in a thermoset and the general basic that you need for this chemistry. You need side groups and some location on the sides of the monomer or the polymer that are reactive. And once the reaction has taken place, depending of the monomer structure you start with, you can achieve different cross-linking density. And that's important because it also distinguishes properties within that class. As a reminder, when we talked about thermoplastics, we had the amorphous and the semicrystalline materials, where one is close, more densely packed, and because of that, the amorphous thermoplastic is a little bit more tougher, and the semicrystalline is a little bit more brittle. When we compare a semicrystalline and a thermoset, the thermoset is more brittle than the semicrystalline. So we're on a range, we're on a scale, but as we're looking at different densities, we also see a scale in the material set of thermosets. So when we have a structure where the molecular weight between the crosslinks is higher, so we have a looser packing, looser density of the covalent bonds, the resulting material has a lower glass transition temperature, lower modulus, and thus lower end-use temperature, but it is a little bit more tough and more flexible. Again, in the range that a thermoset is able to vary. But on the right, you see a higher cross-linking density, and that leads, in comparison to the left, to a higher glass transition temperature, to a higher modulus, to higher end-use temperatures, and increasing solvent resistance. The more covalent bonds and the closer they are, the more you're resistant to chemicals in general and solvents in particular. But the downside is the fracture toughness and flexibility is lower. So important properties of the thermosets or thermosetting materials are the curing behavior. So there is no melting and crystallization, as I said, not reversible, but how we come from a liquid to a solid, that curing behavior is very interesting. The same with the flow behavior. I mentioned before that it's a lower viscosity material, so it can flow in smaller gaps without as much pressure. That's also very interesting. The dimensional changes because of the chemical reaction, you have the chemical shrinkage that's occurring. Thermal properties and mechanical properties, again, are important for the processing, but also for the performance of the parts made out of that. And we're talking more about how that relates to the process and what properties we can get as we look at the material and process interactions.